Hey there, how's it going? So I was at the gym today and I was thinking, hence the way I'm dressed right now, and I was thinking about the cemetery I went to yesterday, the Rogers Daily Cemetery, also the Sutherland Wesleyan Methodist. And it really bothered me as to why Edgar Rogers' headstone doesn't have his death date cut into it. And I thought, you see, there's two reasons of why, two reasons why that would occur. One is that he is not buried there. He died elsewhere and was interred somewhere else and not brought back to Bradford. Two is that nobody bothered to carve or cut the year of his death in the headstone. And I'm thinking, well, why would they not do that? If he's buried there, why would they, was there nobody available to complete that after his death? So what happened? So I decided to skirt a bit around on the internet because things like this just bother me, and I've got to find out as much as I can. And so have a lot of people, apparently, when I get on the internet and start looking up information on Major Edgar Garfield Rogers. Everybody else has jumped on the boat looking for basically the same information as well. Now, even on Find a Grave, the author of the information that's on Find a Grave for Major Rogers, they even cast doubt on whether or not he's even buried there. It even says in the last paragraph of the description, they're not sure whether he is buried there or not. But I found an obituary from the Winnipeg Free Press that was written December the 15th, 1966, one day after Major Rogers' death. He died on the 14th of December, 1966. And for all intents and purposes, he died in Winnipeg, Manitoba. And it states his remains were to be forwarded to Sutherland Cemetery in Bradford, Ontario. And there's no reason why. Nothing I can find that says it was that did not happen. So why was his death date not carved on the headstone? Well, I'm not sure why. His wife died 12 years before him. She died in Bradford, Ontario at the time, so he must have been there as well at that time. And she was buried in the family, what was considered to be the Rogers family cemetery in 1954. So we know that she had died before him because why would they not carve, why would they carve her death date and not his if he died before her? He did have family members who survived him after his death. He had a son who was in Winnipeg. He had four grandchildren and he had two brothers living in Ontario at the time of his death. So there was no reason why his death date couldn't have been carved in, other than they just never got around to doing it. But for all intents and purposes, the information I'm finding clearly states his remains were sent back to Bradford, West Gwillimbury. Now, he was born in Beaton, Ontario, which isn't far from there. And his wife, I believe, was from Bradford. From the Bradford area as well. And hence, that's why they ended up back in the Rogers Cemetery. So, the only mystery is I can't seem to find anything that actually confirms he was actually interred in that cemetery other than in his obituary. Okay, so another little thing I want to clarify about yesterday's little jaunt was. That area was all one cemetery at one point. Remember me going to look for headstones for the Wesleyan Methodist part of the cemetery and we couldn't find anything. And then I stumble across a headstone way off in the bushes for a Susan Keon. Well, there's not much information on Susan Keon on Find a Grave, is that she was born in Midhurst, Ontario in 1802 and died in 1838 and is believed to be the first burial in the Wesleyan Methodist Cemetery. Now remember, the Sutherlands donated the land, well, sold the land to the Wesleyan Methodist congregation in 1835. There's no information on any burials earlier than that. It even says in the transcripts that she was more than likely the first burial. Her headstone is on the Rogers side of the fence, but it doesn't appear that she is any relationship to the Rogers family whatsoever. So that is the only headstone that's directly related to the Wesleyan Methodist Cemetery that's not affiliated with the Rogers family. Okay. Now, the other headstones, remember I said in my video, I wasn't sure, there was Timothy, there was Sarah, there were the two children, Timothy and Mary Jane. I found out that Timothy Rogers is Edgar's grandfather and Sarah is his grandmother. So the two children would have been his aunt and uncle who died very young. His parents are also, well, his mother is buried there. That is the Mary Doherty Rogers headstone, which is just off to the one side. That's his mother. And at the H, can't remember the full name now, H. Lorne Rogers, or Leonard Rogers, H. Leonard Rogers, is his brother. So, yeah, so I was able to find out a couple of things about the Rogers burials, and I can see why in 1950, Edgar Rogers decided to claim that part of the cemetery and separate it from the old Wesleyan Methodist Cemetery, because he had a lot of family members through either marriage or direct blood descendants already buried there. Now, the Daly, that huge monument, that 12-foot or 15-foot monument over there in the bushes, that has about 7 burials affiliated with that monument somewhere around the area. I'm probably all off in that bush. I found those two little footstones. Yeah, and they are related to the Rogers family through marriage. So there you have it. I had to find out. I thought, I got to find out more about this. So there you go. A little bit more info on the Rogers. Oh, you'll probably notice if you look on maps, they say Rogers United Cemetery. Just let me clear something up there before I sign off. United refers to the United Church. All right, the United Church of Canada was created in 1925. And what that happened there was they took to little congregations like the Wesleyan Methodist Churches and other small congregations and united them and created the United Church of Canada. So that is why that United is affiliated with the Rogers Cemetery. Really, it wasn't affiliated with the United Church, because by then the United Church had gone from there. They left there prior to 1930, and the church was demolished in 1930. And that's the main reason why Edgar Rogers took over the section his family were buried in 1950, because it wasn't technically being looked after by anybody. And he just separated it from the Wesleyan Methodist group. Okay, so there you have it. Clear as mud, right? All right, so until the next time, this is Sharon saying bye-bye for now.